You want to shoot Leroy?
If they need, don't give him a gun. Don't give Leroy a gun. Hi, Leroy. So, hey, Bria.
Joy Hunter, the glue.
Are you Halen's big brother?
She's going to be doing the stand.
Halen, come here and talk to me, Halen. What are you going to be singing today? Mary Had a Little Lamb. Huh? You got a booger in your nose. What are you going to be singing?
The National Anthem.
National Anthem. Are you going to help her sing?
I'm Venice.
So what's your name again?
Bria.
Who?
Bria.
Bria? All right, we got Bria right here and Halen. You're the little sister to Halen, ain't you? Are you going to sing when you get bigger? All righty. Well, we'll be filming you guys in a minute, okay? Are you going to sing or do anything? Hi. You're too late.
Abigail, what's the matter? Your camera shy? Not a big a ham as you are for a camera.
Abigail, you're just too slow. Here they are. And Abigail is with us. Hi, baby. And there's her papa right there. But you know, we won't hold that against Abigail.
No.
Not at all.
Papa's blessed to have that.
I've got a little 10-year-old redhead girl. She's this granddaughter. She's this big. Ah! There we go, papa. You just done that to make me mad, didn't you?
Nope.
You didn't? I'm ready. We're ready to go.
Ready, Kev.
All right, baby.
Okay, I think we're ready to go. Okay. Where did Halen go? There's Halen. Where'd you go? Okay, I'll get down here next to you.
You're gonna hurt
yourself. Oh, Papa's got trying to look serious now, ain't he? Wait, I can't get the whole shot down here.
Veterans Day program here today in Campbell County. We're so glad to have everyone here. And before we start, we'd
That's
like
Kevin
to
Walden.
Introduce our county mayor, Mayor Baird. Please come.
Thank you, Kevin. Just like to thank each one of you for coming out today to help us celebrate our Veterans Day service and the service that our veterans have performed for each one of us, the freedoms that we enjoy. Our honor guard, they also help with the our Toys for Tots campaign each year. They take the toy boxes around to each of the businesses, and then they help us on the day that we distribute the toys. They come down in full uniform and distribute the toys for us. Also, I'd like to thank Kevin Walden and his staff for providing the refreshments today. If you haven't taken part in any of the refreshments, they're over there for you. And just once again, thank you for coming. We got such a pretty day to celebrate the Veterans Day. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We are the Campbell County Honor Guard, and we're happy to have you here. We're veteran soldiers, sailors, and Marines from every branch of the military here to honor our veterans on this special day, and we'd like to thank you for being here. We'd like to thank our city and county commissioners and leaders that they continue to support our veterans. And I would like to thank the Honor Guard for always supporting this event under the leadership of Dr. Don Chadwick. And also like to thank Brian Lyke for setting out the tables and providing us electric. And I'd like to thank Ralph for providing all the donuts. Appreciate that. And if you haven't got a chance to get a donut and coffee, please do so before you leave.
I don't leave.
But before we do anything, we'd like to start off with prayer. We'd like to have Brother Asbury come and start us off with prayer.
Our Heavenly Father, it's again we come to you today, Lord. We're thankful, Father, for the hope that we have in risen Savior. We thank you, Lord, for a country, Lord, where we can be free and worship you, Lord, in a way that pleases us and pleases you. Lord, we pray, Father, that you just bless each one that's gathered here today. Lord, we pray for those that are overseas fighting the war, Lord, and doing what's needed to be done. Father, we pray that you just go with us through this service. Father, we pray that you'd be in the midst. Each one of us look up and give you honor and praise. Thank you, Lord, for the hope that we have in risen Savior. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like you to stand and put your hand over your heart as we do the presentation of the flag. And the national anthem this year is going to be sung by 8-year-old Halen Willis, and we want her to come and sing the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleam, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet
good, baby. Very good.
Give Halen Willis another good hand.
The United States Army.
You are happy.
Those missing in action. This is for the MIA's missing in action prisoners of war.
You may be seated. Those that can sit, have a chair. Our honor guard, he's 86, still serving on our honor guard, and he's right next to the U.S. flag there, carrying one of the rifles, and we appreciate him still showing out for funerals. And we got another World War II back here, and we appreciate him as well. And all of our Korean War veterans, if you would just raise your hand and be recognized. Korean War veterans. All of our Vietnam War veterans, raise your hand and be recognized. Vietnam. All of our Gulf and Iraq, Global War on Terrorism, all those veterans, raise your hand. And all of our peacetime veterans, any peacetime veterans, we appreciate your service as well. And any current soldiers or airmen that we have, I know we have Alex Bowling sitting right in front of me. She's currently serving in the United States Air Force. Any more active duty, raise your hand, be notified, recognized. At this time, we'd like to salute our departed comrades with a 21-gun salute. It's the highest honor that we can bestow upon a veteran. After you hear the sound of the rifles, and please prepare yourself for the sound of the rifles, after the rifles you hear taps. Taps is played on every major military installation at the end of the day to signify a time of rest. And after taps is played, we'll have a flag folding presentation here right after that. Officer of the day, salute our departed comrades.
Honor guard, up here,
Attention to the American flag that's before me. The American flag is folded 13 times. The first fold of our flag is a symbol of life. The second fold is a symbol of our belief in eternal life. The third fold is made in honor and remembrance of the veterans departing our ranks who gave a portion of their lives for the defense of our country to attain peace throughout the world. The fourth fold represents our weaker nature, for as American citizen is trusting in God, is Him when we turn in times of peace as well in times of war for His divine guidance. The fifth fold is a tribute to our country, for in the words of Stephen Decatur, our country in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but is still our country, right or wrong. The sixth fold is for where our hearts lie, with our hearts that we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces, for it's through the armed forces that we protect our country and our flag against all her enemies, whether they be found within or without the boundaries of our republic. The eightfold is a tribute to the one who entered into the valley of the shadow of death, that we might see the light of day and to honor Mother for whom it flies on Mother's Day. The ninthfold is a tribute to womanhood, for it's been through their faith, their love, loyalty, and devotion that the character of the men and women who have made this country great has been molded. The tenth fold is a tribute to the Father, for He too has given His sons and daughters for the defense of our country since they were first born. The 11th fold, in the eyes of a Hebrew citizen, represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon and glorifies in their eyes God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The 12th fold, in the eyes of a Christian citizen, represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. The 13th fold is a reminder to all of us of the sacrifice, suffering, and bloodshed by those of the original 13 colonies who never gave up hope nor courage for the day that they would be from the yoke of tyranny upon them by their mother country. Now the flag is completely folded with the stars uppermost in remembrance of our nation's motto, In God We Trust. After it's tucked in, it takes on the appearance of a cocked hat, ever reminding us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington and the sailors and Marines who served under Captain John Paul Jones, who were followed by their comrades and shipmates in the armed forces of the United States, preserving for us the rights, the privileges, and the freedoms that we enjoy today. Give our honor guard another good hand clap. An awesome service. You may be seated.
I like you. I love you.
is still. Gonna tell about the man that I became and hope that it pleased him. There's so much you want to say. There's so much I wanted you to know. When I finally make it home, when I finally make it home, then I gaze upon the throne of the King, frozen in myself. All the questions that I swore I would ask, words just won't come yet. So amazed at what I see, so much more than this old mind can hold.
I'd like to have a special presentation from the representative from AT&T and Mr. Dennis Powers, our state representative, and they have a special presentation.
Thank you, Kevin. What an honor to be here today with the veterans and those that are currently serving. It's truly an honor, and we have so much respect for you. And the Honor Guard, what a great name for them, how appropriate, because they do serve our county with honor, not just here at functions today, but in helping to remember the loved ones that we've lost. Today we have with us Mr. Alan Hill, and every year he does a presentation to our county from AT&T, and he always gives me a call and says, who would you like to, what community organization does a lot of work, who would you like to present it to? And this year it's the Disabled American Vets and the Campbell County Honor Guard. Alan?
Thank you, Representative Powers. Each year, as Dennis said, each year we try to give back to the community where we have customers and people that work for our company. And so this year, again, when Dennis said, here's an organization that does a lot of work, they do these, represent the military funerals, and they just really need some help and a boost. So we're very glad today that we can make this presentation for $1,000 to the Disabled American Veterans here in Campbell County, focused on the Honor Guard and all the services they do. And I just really enjoyed that presentation, 21 gun salute for a lot of our veterans that are. So we just made a commitment too. I'll just say this, I've just found out recently, just this month, we made a commitment over the next 5 years to hire 10,000 veterans to work for AT&T.
Stories, you will more appreciate who she is and what she does.
Thank you. My name is Ray Myhall. My husband and I retired to Campbell County in 2000. But during Operation Desert Storm, we had a program over there where between the Saudi government and the military, we could have soldiers into our home as they were doing a buildup to the Operation Desert Storm. I brought soldiers in and fed them.
Come on.
Did their laundry, let them call home. We had 5,000 homes in Saudi Arabia, and almost every home did this for the American soldiers. It's just one of the many stories that people don't hear about, that when you're overseas, there are things you can do to help the military. We sent thousands of boys off to war, not knowing if they would come home. It was an honor.
Thank you. Appreciate her service. Now I'd like to introduce Leroy Morgan. He is the memorial program chairman, and we want him to come at this time.
Thank you, Kevin. Before we get started, I would like to recognize someone. He just came up. Mr. Russ Martin. Sitting right over here, he is a World War II veteran, 92 years old, and if I'm not mistaken, he is the only POW we have left in the county. Thank you, Russ.
Russ Martin.
Now, if I can, I'm going to read a poem here that I think it was written by a coal miner down in Georgia. It's a Veterans Day poem. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light those who stand for our flag, those who take up the fight. Through days of lore and even today, those who stand for our flag, for these we do pray. In jungle heat and battles across oceans grand, on every continent they took a stand. Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, for our freedom they stand every hour, day, and night. The battles that raged on sea and on land, through the bright blue skies and on desert sand. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, sons and daughters of this land protect the freedom we share. Many days, sometimes years away from family and home, they still fight for our freedom. The battle lives on. Oh, say does the star-spangled banner yet wave for our family, our freedom, for the lives that they save. Young men and women who didn't come home, for the brave who still suffer from those times alone. For these we salute and we honor this day. For those who will serve, we continue to pray. I just want to get up here and say thank y'all for coming out. And this is the biggest crowd we've had so far, I think. And watch the squirrel. We have our bricks still for sale. We have some applications over here, and you do not have to be a citizen of Campbell County as long as you are honorably discharged and served. Thank you, everyone, for being here.
Leroy, did you cut that one just went running through there?
The applications are on back of every program.
What was that?
So you can fill out that application on the back of
every program. A little squirrel went running through here.
And that and $50 will get your loved one on the wall and with a brick. And before we close, we'd like to not only open in prayer, but close in prayer. Amen. So we want our chaplain to come, Brother Asbury, again and close us out in prayer.
Our Heavenly Father, it's again we come to you today, Lord. We're thankful, Father, for our country. Lord, we're free, Lord. We realize that freedom come with a price. Lord, we thank you, Father, for the men and women that have served, and Lord, to those that are serving now. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you bless them, and Lord, bless our country and our nation today. Lord, be with our leaders and help them, Lord, to do what's right in your sight. Help each one of us to lift your name up every day of our lives, for it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thanks for coming out, and again,
so it was such a honor for us to do that. And one of the ladies I was talking to, she said on LAF, on their website, they have a picture of
Hey, I know that website.
Troops.
house. Huh?
I said, I know that website. I work for them.
Okay, go on the website. There's
Could I talk to you just for a minute about what you guys are... Now, what's your full name again?
Thank you.
No, you guys hang around.
Oh, no, we really got to go.
Okay. What is your full name again?
Ray Myhall.
Who?
Ray Myhall.
Ray Myhall.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what did you do? Was it over in Iraq?
No, we lived in Saudi Arabia.
Saudi Arabia.
During Operation Desert Storm, the buildup mm-hmm. of the troops, we had an agreement with the Saudi government
right.
and the U.S. military that they would bring the soldiers into our camp by the busload.
Right.
And we would feed them, do their laundry, and let them call home.
That is awesome.
We did that from September right up to before Christmas when they pulled all the troops back to get ready for the invasion.
Right.
And so I've got awards from the military. I've
yeah.
got pictures of me with my boys as I served them dinner. We
right.
sent them all off with that a hug from a mom.
Wow, that is awesome. Well, thank you for sharing it with us today.
Okay, well, I'm sorry, but I get kind of emotional because...
That's all right.
I just lost a brother.
If you didn't care about it, you wouldn't get emotional.
Well, my brother was Navy. Two wow. grandchildren are Air Force, and I've got two brothers that retired from the Army, so we're
yeah.
not prejudiced against any military.
Right. Well, that's all right.
And I've got my award for my service in Operation Desert Storm, a goldsmith over in Saudi Arabia. One of the American husbands went to him and said, we want you to make something up for the American wives. And
yeah.
it's got Operation Desert Storm, and it's got the tank, the ship, and the rifle, the machine
right.
gun. And it's Operation Desert Storm. This is my thank you
right.
to my husband for what I did during
Well, that's awesome. Thank you for sharing it with us.
Oh, thank you.